The MPhil in Digital Humanities is a 9-month programme at the University of Cambridge. It's a very packed course with lots of different potential directions. We're also working very closely with the university library and the museums and research centre called CRASH.
You would be engaging with galleries, you might be participating in hackathons and mapathons. Oftentimes you'll find yourself building tools for the public.
We have people who've worked in archaeology, we have people from a scientific background, we've got people from a creative background, and that's really reflective of the kind of broad church that digital humanities is.
If you join us, you'll be exploring digital tools and methods in a practical way, and you'll be looking also at theories of the technological, understanding how to think about technology, how to think about culture, so it's a mix of theory and practice. At Cambridge Digital Humanities, we have people researching science fiction and futures. We have people exploring how to link collections. We have people thinking critically about what it means to be a digital human these days.
A lot of the work that you do is collaborative, and a lot of the work that you do is outward facing.
There's lots of scope for interdisciplinary research at Cambridge, from, you know, law and history, art history and literature, anthropology and architecture, and the place that many of those subjects meet is through the digital.
There's a lot of science-driven activity, there's a lot of programming-driven activity, and then there's a kind of critical aspect to digital humanities, which is really, you know, driven by the big humanities questions.
Cambridge is really a melting pot of disciplines. There are some faculties that are centuries old, and then there are some faculties and departments that are responding to new questions. And I feel that lends a certain political urgency to the discipline.
You can't understand human cultural production today without going through the digital. You can't study contemporary popular photography without thinking about smartphones and the image augmentation algorithms that they contain. But as we engage with those algorithms critically, socially, technically, aesthetically, we can also use them to study human cultural history and human cultural production. We can turn the technology back on itself, and that's a large part of what the digital humanities is about.
There's huge new possibilities for thinking about knowledge production using digital tools. Digital humanities is growing because digital culture is increasingly pervasive and increasingly important.
The digital humanities gives you not just a new bunch of knowledge about what the digital is and digital culture, but it gives you a new way of thinking. Because the digital humanities is a new field, a little bit like studying computers just after World War II, research students can grapple with really fundamental questions and make significant contributions to the research, you know, rewriting some of the basic assumptions of our field.
Digital humanities lets you ask questions it would be very hard to explore in other ways. For example, how can we really understand the millions and billions of tweets and what they mean and how they produce a new kind of writing?
Cambridge Digital Humanities will have a particularly close relationship to these collections and the experts that care for them. That's because we see a foundation of skills in digital humanities as vital to the future of the profession in libraries, archives, museums and galleries.
And we're seeing huge opportunities for people to move on in all aspects, really. Some people go into what you'd consider to be more traditional programming work. Some people go into collections-based work. And lots of people stay in academia and embrace, I suppose, the two big aspects of digital humanities, one of which is doing it, and the second of which is what it means to do it.
When I took my doctorate, this degree didn't exist, and I wish it had. I think it's going to be really innovative, really daring, and it's going to bring together a fantastically exciting community of scholars.
There's lots more information on the website. Please have a look around, and if you think this is for you, we'd love to hear from you.